So he will be presenting tomorrow, so if you want to catch his presentation as well. But I'm based in Sydney, Sydney, Australia, and despite the Canadian accent, I've actually lived there for 25 years now, so I am, you know, a true blue, dinky dyed Aussie, despite what you may think. So I wanted to start this demo just with a reference to the belief that we hold at Atlassian, which is that most of the great human achievements of our lifetime were the result of teamwork. And I mean, this is something that really underpins Atlassian's origins, and also it drives our mission to unleash the potential of every team. So today, I'm going to be talking about team collaboration through Confluence. And I'm going to be covering off how Confluence is a great tool for unlocking, for evolving your workplace. I'm then going to talk about how teams use Confluence, and I'm going to also cover off how Confluence can grow with your organization, and also cover off some of the deployment options available for Confluence. So hopefully you come away from this demo with a bit of a sense of why people love Confluence and why it's a great tool for collaboration in your workplace. So when it comes to making the transition to the modern workplace, you need tools. You need tools that align with the way that people work, that align with how or where people conduct business, and also that allow for different communication preferences. And when you think about it, tools can actually influence the culture of a company. So they have the power really to drive a company either down the path of being rigid and bureaucratic and top-down driven, or alternatively, they also have the ability to lead the company in another direction, which is to be flexible and adaptive and potentially more efficient, one would also argue. So we actually conducted a survey around this particular topic, and we found that people were overall very interested in learning about the benefits of an open culture and working environment. So with this survey, we found that 60% of the respondents were really interested in having access to tools that would provide them with visibility of what their teammates were working on and also allow them to contribute to that work. We found that 72% of the respondents wanted to have access to technology that would help foster openness and transparency and open communication to add to that within their organization. And lastly, 87% of the respondents wanted to work for companies that valued openness and transparency and basically provided them with teammates that they felt that they could trust. So this is where Confluence comes in. And we view Confluence as a really powerful tool for collaboration and teamwork. Whether you're going to be creating documents or using it for project collaboration, Confluence is a tool that can allow you to share ideas, to build community, and basically get the work done. So we feel that Confluence embodies the three principles that are really crucial for a modern workplace. So that is, everyone has a voice, information flows freely, and work gets done. So we feel that every team has the capability of getting value out of Confluence. Typically, we find that adoption grows pretty organically when it comes to Confluence within an organization. Most usually we'll see that software development teams are the first teams to take up usage of Confluence. And then from there, it kind of spreads out to other teams. But ultimately, we really do feel that all teams can get value out of Confluence. And the more people that use Confluence within an organization, the more value teams will derive from it. So just to give a bit of an example of how teams are using Confluence and the value that they derive from it, firstly, software teams. So software teams are typically using Confluence to basically assist with their product releases or to help with any sort of software projects. And the benefit that they get from Confluence is owing to the fact that it is a tool that integrates perfectly with Jira. So the software team members can switch really easily between the two applications. And also, Confluence is really powerful at allowing those teams to create deeper context around the issues that they actually create in Jira, and they can do that contextual work within Confluence. Secondly, we've got IT teams. So IT teams will frequently use Confluence for developing documentation, and particularly that is to help their team members quickly find the answers that they need and basically resolve issues more quickly. So enterprises can scale their IT service desk by integrating with Confluence as a knowledge base. So we actually did another survey, and this one was around teams who have integrated Jira Service Desk with Confluence, and we found that with those teams, 45% of their issues, their IT issues, were being deflected because of that integration. So that frees up their team members to, you know, move on to other work which isn't repetitive. Water break, sorry. And lastly, when it comes to business teams, I mean, we find that marketing teams can use Confluence to develop their programs, legal teams can be using it for contracts, and the list goes on from there. Project documentation, for example. And really the benefit when it comes to business teams is having that visibility across all the teams of an organization, so you can easily see what's going on with other teams and what's happening with their projects. So that leads me to the fact that last year we reached the milestone of 100 million pages created in Confluence. And for people who love data, I love data, that essentially equates to a Confluence page being created every 1.3 seconds, which is kind of crazy. But you may ask, what are people doing? What are they using all these pages for? And really the uses can vary a lot. And it can be everything from really kind of general use cases, such as meeting notes, which are used by every team, or should be, and through to things like blogs, so communicating information through to the rest of the company, through to more specific use cases, such as product roadmaps or project documentation, assigning tasks to team members, for example. But Confluence is great because it is supremely flexible and very expansive. So it means that there's no limit to the type of content that you can create and no limit to the amount of content you can create, as evidenced by the 100 billion pages. So we find that there are three most common use cases of Confluence. The first of which is reference documentation. So what this refers to is really how a team can create and share documents, which can really capture team knowledge and retain that knowledge as well. Secondly, we have knowledge bases. So this is when a team is creating documentation that ultimately allows other people or their audience to self-serve. So that external user can basically access this information and find the answer to the question that they have. And lastly, we have project collaboration. So this is when team members are using Confluence as a way to share their ideas around a particular project. And typically they're using social media constructs like comments, likes, app mentions, and it's all about closing the loop on feedback and trying to move projects forward. So let's have a quick look at project collaboration, which is probably the most common use case of Confluence. So pretty much this starts when a page is created and members are invited to access this page. It's published, and then the work starts from there. So this page or even space can be used to share ideas and also deal with issues. So if problems or obstacles come up during a project, you can track those issues in Confluence and basically try and keep the project on track. So collaborative editing is something that we introduced late last year, and it's a really useful feature when it comes to project collaboration. So you can always have a sense of who is actually using or who is actually on page editing, and that is indicated by the flags, which shows what content is being created on the page. You can use things such as the status labels to indicate progress, and app mentions also will kind of allow for accountability as well. So once you're ready to publish a document, you'll then be prompted with this dialogue, and from there all of the changes that were made to your page will be published and accessible. And I should also note that, you know, if you are using Confluence for documentation, then whilst you're in that editing process, your audience will still see the previously published version of that page. So moving on to the documentation use case that I mentioned, there are so many forms of documentation, and it ranges through from specifics to software, so how software works and functions, but can range through to things like release notes and requirements. So our view of documentation is it should always aim to do two things. It should inform users, and it should help users be successful. So this is where documentation is a really useful part of Confluence. Cool. And then lastly, we've got knowledge base. The example that I've got here is referencing how IT teams can capture knowledge to scale their operations. So you can use how-to articles or troubleshooting guides, and basically allow for your users to self-serve. So in this example, if someone is looking for information on printers, they can try to find that information themselves. And this is an example of Jira Service Desk portal. So if they can't find the answer they're looking for, they can then go on to raise an issue. So Confluence is really core to the Atlassian suite. We know that 72% of our customers are actually using multiple Atlassian products. And whether it's with Jira Service Desk or with Jira Core or Software or HipChat, the integrations are super smooth and will basically help Confluence become more powerful. Deployment options. This was referenced in the keynote. We have three different options available. There is the cloud version, which is great if you want to get up and running quickly and easily, if you don't want to have to deal with setup yourself or the sort of the complexity of hosting, that's all managed for you. We have server, which is where you're obviously hosting your instance on your own hardware. And this is really, it's great for customers who want to manage their own setup, and they're happy to deal with the hosting situation. And then lastly, we have data center, which is very similar to server, but it gives you, in addition to hosting on your own hardware, you have high availability, you have performance at scale, and you also have disaster recovery. So it's mostly useful for enterprise companies. So, why Confluence? Firstly, and hopefully as I've covered off, it's the one centralized place that you can collaborate as a team and also with other teams as well. So you can share ideas, you can build community, and you can get the work done. All in one place. Secondly, it is trusted by over 30,000 companies, and all of those range in size from startups through to Fortune 500 companies. It also offers first-class Jira integration, and it works really well with other Atlassian products. Plus, I should add that we have 600 add-ons in the marketplace for Confluence, so that really covers off every sort of edge case that you can think of for usage of Confluence. And then lastly, it grows with you. So if your company is growing and expanding, then it has the ability to scale. So I should mention that there are hundreds of Atlassian partners around the world who can help you customize your instance exactly to your organization's needs. So, and these are just a couple of the companies that I mentioned before, the 30,000 businesses using Confluence. So I just want to finish off by leaving you with this quote from Docker. I think like a lot of companies, when they, prior to using Confluence, they were relying on email and word processing and spreadsheets, and they realized they came to a point where the company was growing that they really needed a centralized system that was going to allow them to communicate across teams and also preserve knowledge. So Confluence basically helped them realize a solution that helped them get all their work into one place and everyone literally on the same page. And it really allowed them to streamline their processes and manage their plans and future resourcing. So yes, I don't think do I have time for Q&A? No? Okay, no, getting off the stage. Thank you so much for coming along, and I'm actually gonna be at the Confluence booth after this, so if you have any questions, then please come and see me. Thank you.